This is a quick demonstration on how to use this general interactive digital head brain project. On the left hand side of the screen, you see a few simple instructions. And on the right side, you see the image actually. This is what is known as the sagittal section of the head and the brain. These are the types of images that we get in magnetic resonance imaging, MRI images, during clinical practice. And therefore, it is incumbent on the pharma student to be able to identify each and every structure when they see a sagittal section of the head and the brain. So what we've done, we have hyperlinked every square millimeters of this image, such that when the student holds his mouse cursor, when it becomes a hand, immediately that region shows up. The identification of that place and a few quick simple description. So therefore here you can see it's the parietal bone of the skull. This is the scalp. This is the superior sagittal sinus. This is the parietal bone of the brain. This is the corpus callosum. This is the cerebellum. This is the midbrain. The students can go either horizontally and they can see section by section what is known as the axial section. They can go vertically, what is known as the coronal section. They can go oblique or they can go randomly and they can study that. So therefore this becomes a very easy to use, a very user friendly and a fun way of learning about the brain. We have created this project using scripts, ActiveX controls, hyperlinks, bookmarks, and has been rendered in the form of a single brain web page.
Whole brain. Now you see a relevant part of the brain. So this is another interactive image. Cerebellum is a small brain which is in the back of the skull.
Is it an MRI?
No, this is histology of the cerebellum, but I'm going to show you that.
Oh.
The unique beauty of the cerebellum is it's got a lot of connections. Circuits coming in within the cerebellum, circuits going out. You know, you can imagine teaching all these things to the student is really crazy. And you know, they go up to sleep, as somebody says. So, we have again created another system. Can we go to the next slide, please? So, these are some screenshots. And again, I'm going to show you the interactive video. The same things I'm going to show you.
Welcome to our next demonstration on how to use the interactive digital cerebellum. As I told you, the cerebellum is got a lot of circuits, intracerebral circuits, inputs, outputs, etc., etc., and the students have a lot of difficulty trying to understand them. So therefore, I've created this simple demonstration of how to use the interactive digital cerebellar circuits. Let's say the student clicks here, and immediately all the inputs to the cerebellum from the cerebral cortex, spinal cord, vestibular system, they all open up in front of the student. And the student wants to click on any one individual circuit that also is available for him to view. And if he wants to go back to the welcome screen page, he can see that. Let's say he wants to see what are the circuits inside the cerebellum. And therefore, this is one particular view of the cerebellar circuits inside. And if he wants to see in another view of it, he can get the same view. And if he wants to see any one individual, he can click on that and that will also appear in the third fashion in front of him. Then he can go back again. And let's say he wants to see what are the outputs. He can see the outputs again from three different perspectives. And finally, if he wants to see the entire summary of all the cerebellar circuits, all he has to do is just click once and then the circuits inside and outside and within the cerebellum will all appear in front of him in a sequential fashion, and then if he clicks again the next circuits will appear and so on and so forth. They'll keep appearing from different parts and different perspectives. Again, this is a very fun and easy way to learn about the cerebellar circuits rather than from reading textual matter from the books. The students find it very easy, very useful, very user friendly, and it has attained a lot of great reviews.
Making students more interested in what they are seeing. So this is the second one. You see the third one, and this is the hypothalamus. That's another part of the brain. Now this contains not circuits, but nuclei. Nuclei means small collection of cells which perform different functions. Now students have a lot of problem understanding what are the names of the nuclei, what do they function, and what do they do. So these are some screenshots, and these are some of the screenshots, and I'm going to show you right now the same
demonstration of the effective digital hypothalamic nuclei project. This is the first of the three sub-projects. This is a menu screen. Let's say the student wants to see what is the dorsal medial nucleus. He clicks on it and takes it to the dorsal medial nucleus. He can see the location and the shape of the dorsal medial nucleus. Then again, he wants to see, let's say for example, he wants to see the posterior nucleus and takes it to the posterior nucleus. Now let's say he wants to see all the nuclei together. And then he takes into all the nuclei, and then when he's looking at it, he tries to figure out what is this ARN. He can't figure it out. So he clicks on that and it takes him and tells him that this is an RQA nucleus. While he's doing that, let's say he wants to do a self-assessment quiz. So he clicks on that and he takes into the quiz. And while he's trying to answer all these nuclei, he cannot figure out what is this one. So therefore he clicks on that and tells him that it's a ventromedial nucleus. So therefore this student can go back and forth in multiple different ways and he can see all the nuclei. This is the second of the three sub-projects. Again, this is the welcome screen. The student is faced with the hypothalamus. This is the location of the hypothalamus, but the governance nucleus. Now he wants to see the preoptic nucleus. He clicks on it and it appears in front of him. Then he wants to see the suprachiasmatic nucleus and he clicks and it appears in front of him. And now he wants to see the paraventricular nucleus and it appears in front of him. So he can keep clicking and one by one the nuclei will appear. And this is the third of the three sub-projects. This is even more easy. Again, he's got the blank hypothalamus in front of him, and he just clicks once, and the preoptic nucleus appears. Then he clicks a second time, and the suprachiasmatic appears. Then the paraventricular, the anterior, the supraoptic, and so on. As he clicks, each and one by one, the nuclei keeps appearing in front of him. So as you can see, this is very user-friendly, and it shows the nuclei of the hypothalamus from different perspectives, and it makes it very easy for the students not only to understand the location, shape, size, and it's also a very fun way of learning.